गुड आफ्टरनून मैम।
गुड आफ्टरनून बेटा, गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीबॉडी। गगन, आई जस्ट मेक यू द को होस्ट।
यस, गुड आफ्टरनून मैम।
बेटा
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम।
गुड आफ्टरनून। ओके, सो लेट मी स्टार्ट माय क्लास। इज द स्क्रीन विजिबल टू एवरीबॉडी?
यस मैम।
यस मैम।
ओके, सो लेट अस सी व्हाट वी हैव। जस्ट मेक अ लिटिल समरी ऑफ व्हाट वी हैव डन। सो वी हैव अ फंक्शन एफ ऑफ एक्स। वी रोट इट्स पावर सीरीज एंड मैकलॉरिन सीरीज। फाइन, पावर सीरीज इज summation n from 0 to infinity a n x minus a raised to power n, and Maclaurin series, okay, sorry, not a n, it is nth derivative at a upon n factorial, and Maclaurin series was n from 0 to infinity f nth derivative at 0 x raised to power n upon n factorial. And also we saw that if you just take this f of a, this is called Taylor polynomial of order 0. Polynomial of order 0. If you take the first two terms, f dash a into x minus a, this is called Taylor polynomial of order 1. If you take up to second derivative, so you have f double dash a x minus a square upon 2 factorial, that is called Taylor polynomial of order 2, and so on. So this is what we have done. And also I told you that if you have f of x and you construct a power series using f of x, power or Maclaurin, whatever, okay, you construct a power series, this power series may not converge back to f of x. Fine. So let us dig into this part more. So we are saying that you have a function f of x, and for that function you are writing a power series. Fine. And that power series may not converge to that function again. So here I will give you two examples. So the first example is you have f of x is equal to 1 upon 1 minus x. We have already discussed this thing. So if you write a Maclaurin series for this function here, power series or Maclaurin series, obviously both they are same. Just the difference is in Maclaurin series, your center is 0. So we have f of x is equal to 1 upon 1 minus x. We have already written the power series or Maclaurin series for this. That is 1 plus x squared plus x cube and so on. But we know this is a power series for this function. This is convergent. This is convergent only when mod of x is less than 1, because this is a geometric progression with common ratio equals to x. So it means that the sum is possible only when mod x is less than 1, and the sum will be equal to first term upon 1 minus common ratio. So we say that we can see that this series is equal to the original function from where we have generated only when mod x is less than 1. So you can write 1 upon 1 minus x is equal to 1 plus x square and so on for mod x less than 1. So that is why you must have noticed I am not writing f of x is equal to the series which we are generating, because the sum of the series may not be equal to f of x. Is that thing clear to everybody? Okay, so I'll give you one more example. You look at this function. We have another function f of x is equal to 0 when x is 0, and this is equal to e raised power minus 1 by x square when x is not equal to 0. Okay, now let us write down its Maclaurin series. Write down its Maclaurin series. Okay, now you can see that what will be first derivative? Can you tell me at 0? Can you tell me what will be the first derivative at 0? Anybody?
Zero.
how you are computing this derivative.
Zero.
How you
zero
f of 0 plus h minus f of 0 upon h limit h going to 0. This is how you will compute it. So this will be e raised to minus 1 by h square minus 0 upon h limit h going to 0. So this is 0 by 0 form, right? So you can just compute the limit. This will be 0. Can you see, everybody? This will be 0. Yes, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
We have made left hand derivative.
Yes, beta, you can compute the right hand also. That also you'll get 0. Fine? This is the definition for derivative. Why I'm using this definition? Because here at x is equal to 0, function is defined differently. And because obviously e raised to minus infinity, that also you can consider as 0. So the derivative is 0. Here you can take h negative also, beta. That also because you have h square. So you will get 0 only again. Left hand derivative and right hand derivative both are 0. Fine. So here if you compute the second derivative also, all the derivatives at 0, they will be 0. You can just compute. You can do the calculations. These are your plus 1, plus 2 part. Fine. So it means that if you write the Maclaurin series, therefore Maclaurin series of f of x is what? F of 0 plus f dash 0 into x plus f double dash 0 into x square plus f triple dash 0 into x, sorry, by 2 factorial, x cube by 3 factorial and so on. So what is this? This is 0 plus 0 plus 0 plus 0. So Maclaurin series is just 0. So now you see, this series is always convergent because this is a 0 plus 0 plus 0. And this is equal to the original function only at x is equal to 0. Can you see? The Maclaurin series which you write is convergent for all values of x and its sum is 0. And it is equal to the original function only at x is equal to 0. Because original function is 0 only at x is equal to 0. And everywhere else it is non-zero. So here this is an example. So from this example, we see that the Maclaurin series of f of x is 0, n from 0 to infinity, right? Let me write like this, xn, fine? And hence, always convergent. But this Maclaurin series sum is equal to f of x only at x is equal to 0. So what I'm trying to say is that for a function, when you write the Maclaurin series or the power series, the sum of that series may not be equal to f of x. Is that thing clear? Okay, let me read. So you have f of x, you write power series or Maclaurin series of that function. If it is convergent, power series and Maclaurin series, they are the infinite series, so you have to check the convergence also. So if this series is convergent, the sum may not be equal to f of x. Jisse aapne shuru kiya tha. You started from f of x, you constructed a power series, and then you find the sum of that power series. That sum may not be equal to f of x. So you can look at the example, look at two examples above. Is that thing clear? Either your series is not convergent, as in the first example, and in the second example, all the series is convergent, but the sum is not equal to the value of the function. So this observation leads us to think that for what values of x, the Taylor series converges to its generating function. Generating function matlab the one which you started with.
Ma'am, please explain this again.
Okay, beta. So I'm saying that you have a function f of x, You write the power series or Maclaurin series of that function. And then you find the sum of that Maclaurin series if it is convergent. It may not be equal to the original function you started with. I have given you the examples above. So that leads to the following question. That for what values of x, the Taylor series will converge to its generating function? Because that is what we want. Otherwise, there is no point that you write the Taylor series for a function and that series is not converging to the original function itself. So then it is useless. So we want to know for what values of x, the Taylor series which we just wrote will be convergent to its original generating function. Is that thing clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, to answer this question, till now, everything was, we were doing exercise 8.9. So now to answer this question, we are moving ahead to the next exercise, that is 8.10. So in 8.10, we'll try to answer this question that for what values of x, Taylor series.
What is generating function?
The one we started with. So this is the generating function. Okay. Just the one from where we generated the power series. This is not a fixed name. I'm just calling it as a generating function. Is that okay?
Yes.
Is that thing clear to everybody? Then only you will be able to connect to the next exercise. So let me say again, given a function f of x, you create a power series from that function. Now you want to know the sum of that power series is again that original function or not. Or for what values of x, the sum of the power series is equal to the value of the generating function. So the function which we started with, I'm calling that function as a generating function. So to answer this question, we have the following theorem, which is called Taylor's theorem. To answer this, we have the following theorem. So what is the theorem? The name is Taylor's theorem. Right. So what is Taylor's theorem? So before that, let me ask you, do you remember Rolle's theorem?
Yes.
So what was the statement? Can you tell me?
Statement.
Rolle's theorem. And then there was one more theorem.
Ma'am,
there were three conditions.
Then there is one point for sure in the interval AB such that f dash c is zero.
Yes, ma'am.
This was Rolle's theorem. Fine. And after that, there was a generalization of Rolle's theorem. When you don't have this condition, what is that theorem called? Lagrange mean value theorem?
Mean value theorem.
Okay. So that is when you have a function which is continuous on AB and differentiable on open interval AB, f of A is not equal to f of B, then there exists a point C in the open interval AB such that
f of B minus f A by B minus A.
This was there. Do you remember? Okay. Now you see here, suppose you have this a function f of x, and you have written a Taylor series for this function about A. So what will be the Taylor series? That will be this. Clear? Okay, for the function f of x, this is going to be the Taylor series. Now if I just take first, and suppose my interval is, A to B, then this is valid for every x in the interval. So in particular, write f of B. Okay, so suppose I'm writing it equal to. We'll discuss that under what conditions you can write it equal to. Then f of B will be f of A plus B minus A f dash a plus b minus a square f double dash b by 2 factorial and so on. Okay, now from here, if I just take these three, these two terms on the right hand side, so I have, and I'm neglecting all these terms. So then the Lagrange mean value theorem tells me that if you replace a with c, then for sure you have an equality sign. Can you connect? From here you can see that f of b is f of a plus b minus a into f dash c. Can you see better? So Lagrange mean value theorem tells me that if you're just taking the first two terms, then if you replace this a with the c, which is sure that such c will exist, then this equality sign is there. This thing is clear to everybody?
Ma'am, could you repeat, please?
Okay, beta. So I'm saying that you have a function f of x. Let us not put this equal to sign. You have a function f of x. You write its Taylor series. Is that okay? No problem. Now I'm just taking these two terms. And I want to see that how these two terms and my original function is related. Fine? Ye clear hai? So what I'm doing is, this. I have written this Taylor series and my interval is a to b. So it means that at x is equal to b also, I can write this Taylor series. I can just put x is equal to b. So what I'm saying is, if x is equal to b and I am taking the first two terms on the in the Taylor series, then from Lagrange mean value theorem, you see, this is Lagrange mean value theorem, that f of b will be f of a plus b minus a into f dash c, where c is a number between a and b. So Lagrange mean value theorem tells me that if you replace this a with that c, then you have an equality sign here. Clear?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Ma'am, ये जो हम जैसे Rolle's theorem में करते थे, f dash c equal to zero करते थे, तो इस point में भी f of b equal to f of a हो गया. तो
no, f of b is not equal to f of a. That condition is in Rolle's theorem. We don't have that condition, na? F of a and f of b, they are different. They may be equal. In that case, f dash c will be zero. Otherwise, they are equal. They are not equal.
Excuse me.
Okay, beta, can you just wait? Let me connect everything, then we will discuss. Okay, so this Taylor's theorem, this was, if you just take the first two terms on right hand side, that is your Lagrange mean value theorem. So Taylor's theorem is a generalization. So let me write down the statement. It says that if f and its first n derivatives, that is f dash, f double dash, f nth derivative, are continuous on closed interval AB, and f nth derivative is differentiable on open interval AB, then there exists a number c in the open interval AB such that f of b is equal to f of a plus b minus a into f dash a plus b minus a square by 2 factorial into f double dash a plus b minus a cube by 3 factorial f triple dash a and so on, n plus 1th derivative at c upon n plus 1 factorial into b minus a. Okay, so we are saying here that you can keep the first, this is nth order polynomial till here. Let me write like this.
Ma'am, ये ST का मतलब क्या है?
Such that. Okay, let me write it completely. Such that
ma'am, ऐसे general form तो नहीं होगी ना, जैसे आपने लिखा Taylor's theorem is a generalization, मतलब उसका है ना?
Lagrange mean value theorem. Okay, so we had Lagrange mean value theorem is still here. Yes, beta. Let me first complete, then you can ask, beta, please. So I'm saying your Lagrange mean value theorem is still here. That tells you that if function is continuous and its derivative is existing on the open interval AB, then you have f of b minus f of a upon b minus a is equal to f dash a. And the Taylor's theorem is a generalization which tells you that if the nth order derivative up to nth order derivative, they are continuous on the closed interval AB and fn is further differentiable on the open interval AB, it means that n plus 1th derivative exists. Okay, then you can write this fb is equal to this nth order polynomial plus the next term which is computed at c. So can you see, this gives you an idea that you can just keep finite number of terms in your Taylor series. What we have done, in general, there are infinite number of terms in the Taylor series, but all those terms, extra terms, by Taylor's theorem are replaced by this term, where what we have done, we have replaced B with A with C. This A, instead of A, you will write a C, where C is a number between A, B. Okay, so don't worry if you don't understand it, this thing. I'll explain it in another sense also. Just wait. Just try
excuse
to
me,
see.
Ma'am.
Yes, beta.
Ma'am, wouldn't there be minus b minus a to the power n plus 1 in f?
In the?
In the last term.
Yeah. Okay, b minus a raised to power n plus 1, obviously. Right? Here only we are replacing a with c. That's it. Is that okay? Is that thing clear? Just this is a generalization of Lagrange mean value theorem. You have these terms as such. This is nothing but Taylor series. And after that, you had infinitely many terms more. So what we are doing is we are replacing all those terms with this term where we are replacing A with C. Okay? Is that okay? Okay, now the next thing is we have Taylor's formula. Just give me a minute.
Ma'am, can you please explain this again?
Hello, yes, are you there, students?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, can you please explain this again?
Please, if you don't understand, just wait. Let me move ahead, then I'll come back. Okay. So this is the statement of Taylor series. So the next thing is something called Taylor's formula. So what is Taylor's formula? Taylor's formula is, if f has derivatives of all order in an open interval I containing a, then for each positive integer n, and for each x in I, we can write f of x is equal to f of a plus x minus a f dash a plus x minus a square upon 2 factorial f double dash a and so on, x minus a raised to power n upon n factorial f nth derivative at a plus f n plus 1th derivative at c upon n plus 1 factorial x minus a raised to power n plus 1, where c is a number between x and a. So you see here, we are saying that if you have a function f of x and its derivatives, they exist on an interval I is an interval containing A. Fine. Then obviously if it contains A and you have written a Taylor series with center A, then you see these are the terms of the Taylor series. Everybody can see these are the terms of Taylor series, and there are infinitely many terms more, but you can replace all those terms with this term. You can write f n plus 1th derivative, f n plus 1th derivative at c. So you have to replace a with c, that's it. This formula is called Taylor formula. Here you see you have an equality sign. Can you see? Before this, we were just writing the Taylor series. We were not saying they are equal to, the Taylor series is equal to f of x. Now I'm replacing the infinite part here with this term. And then I'm writing equality sign. I'm not proving these theorems. I'm just telling you the statements. So it means that, now can you tell me what is this? Tell me, students, what is this? This much part.
Normal Taylor.
Normal
Taylor.
Polynomial. This is Taylor polynomial, not series. But a series is infinite. So this is Taylor polynomial of order n. Do you remember? If you are keeping up to nth derivative, that is Taylor polynomial of order n. So we denote it with pnx. And this term we called remainder after n terms, and we call it Rnx. Okay, I will repeat it. So then it means that f of x is equal to Pnx plus Rnx, where Pnx is Taylor polynomial of order n. And Rnx is remainder after n terms. And this is equal to n plus 1th derivative at c upon n plus 1 factorial into x minus a raised to power n plus 1, where c is a number between x and a. Clear? So this is called Taylor formula. This is called Taylor formula. Right? Is that thing okay?
No, ma'am. Can you explain again?
I'm so many.
Tell me what you are not getting. What is not clear?
Ma'am, iska proven nahi kya?
Sorry, beta.
Ma'am, iska proven nahi kya?
Proof? You want the proof?
Iska proven, ma'am.
Improvement? I didn't get you what you are saying.
Proof
is not in our syllabus, but obviously it is there in the book. If you want to do that, I can that give you the proof separately in maybe tute class, or we can have a separate class for that. Okay, so let me repeat again.
Can you tell about?
I'll take an example. Then we will see what.
Can you scroll up?
After that, I will take an example, because I think how much time is left. We have 10 more minutes. So I will explain with an example. Okay. Noted. So for the moment, forget about all these terms which I told you. If you don't understand, I'm giving you an example, and then again I will explain what I was saying. So you look at this function. F of x is equal to e raised to power x. Fine. So I'm writing its Taylor series about x is equal to 0, or that is your Maclaurin series. I know that I can write its Maclaurin series as, we have already written that, 1 plus x plus x square upon 2 factorial plus x cube upon 3 factorial plus x4 upon 4 factorial and so on. Fine. Now, I'm not writing this equal to this, because I have to check the convergence and then I have to find the sum also. But from Taylor's formula, I can write e raised to power x is equal to pnx plus rnx, where pnx is Taylor polynomial of order n. This is from Taylor's formula. P and x is Taylor polynomial of order n. So this is 1 plus x square upon 2 factorial plus x raised to power n upon n factorial. And what will be Rnx? Can you tell me? Tell me, beta. What will be
Rnx? N plus 1.
It will be n plus 1th derivative of f at c into x raised to power n plus 1 upon n plus 1 factorial, where c is a number between a and 0, a and x. A here is 0, center is 0, a and x. So 0 and x. Now is this thing clear? So this term we call it as remainder after n terms. Clear, beta? So this Taylor formula tells you that you can put an equality sign if you replace this infinite part of Taylor series with Rnx. Rnx is nothing but n plus 1th derivative at c, where what is c? C is just a number between 0 and x. You don't know what c is. The only information you have is it is a number between 0 and x. Now, is that thing clear? Yes, no?
Yes.
Yes. Okay, so let me give you further this Taylor. Further, we have this result. What was our aim? We wanted to know when the Taylor series will converge to the original function. This was our idea. So we have this result. If the remainder term goes to zero, okay, goes to zero as n goes to infinity, okay. So if Rnx goes to zero for n going to infinity in whatever interval, say x belongs to I, then you can write, so you see, from Taylor's formula, you have this thing, e raised to power x is equal to Pnx plus Rnx. And suppose this thing goes to zero as n goes to infinity. So let us take limit n going to infinity, both sides. So what you will get, limit n going to infinity, Pnx plus Rnx. So this Rnx will be zero. So what is this as n goes to infinity? This is f of a plus f dash a into x minus a plus f double dash a upon 2 factorial x minus a square and so on. This is your Taylor series. Can you see? So in it means that the original function will be equal to Taylor series if the remainder goes to 0 as n goes to infinity. So let me summarize again. So we are saying that f of x is equal to Pnx plus Rnx. This is your Taylor formula, where Pnx is Taylor polynomial of order n, and Rnx is remainder after n terms. This is equal to n plus 1th derivative at c upon n plus 1 factorial into x minus a raised to power n plus 1, where c is a number between a and x. C is between a and x. Fine? So further we are saying, if Rnx goes to 0 for whatever value of x, then Taylor series sum is equal to, or you can write it more precisely as, if Rnx goes to 0, then Taylor series is convergent and its sum is equal to the original function f of x. So this is what we wanted to know, that for what values of x, the Taylor series is convergent to its generating function. So from Taylor's formula, we have f of x is equal to Pnx plus Rnx. So Pnx is your Taylor polynomial of order n. RnX, you have this formula. RnX, you have this formula. Now, all you have to check is, if RnX goes to zero, then your Taylor series is convergent to its generating function. Is that thing clear? Fine. Now, let
us... So RnX ka function usme ek doubt tha.
Yes.
Ma'am, isme n plus 1 kyun le rahe hain? Hum n plus 1 ki jagah simple n nahi le sakte?
No, beta. Already we have considered till n terms. And that involves in the proof also. You see, you have these n terms already, right? And all the terms which are after this, they are replaced by this. Fine? They are replaced by this term. So there is n plus 1th derivative. So main aapko iska proof, I'm not giving you the proof. That is why you may be confused. But if you want to see, you can see the proof in the book. That is very simple, not a hard proof. Fine?
Okay.
ये पूरा सीरीज ओके सो आफ्टर दैट यू हैव x माइनस a n प्लस 1 अपॉन n प्लस 1 फैक्टोरियल f n प्लस 1 a आफ्टर दैट यू हैव x माइनस a रेस्ड पावर n प्लस 2 अपॉन n प्लस 2 फैक्टोरियल f n प्लस 2 a एंड सो ऑन सो वी आर सेइंग दैट ऑल दीस टर्म्स दे आर रिप्लेस्ड बाय rnx व्हिच इज इक्वल टू n प्लस 1th डेरिवेटिव यहां पे a था देन यू हैव c हियर Okay, at c into x minus a raised to power n plus 1 upon n factorial, n plus 1 factorial. So we are saying that Taylor formula is claiming that these terms, they are replaced by rnx. Okay, now Ma'am, further if you prove that rnx...
x aur a ke beech mein rahegi na?
Yeah, c is a number between x and a. So that is what I am writing again and again. Fine. Now let us, we have just 2 minutes. Let us just discuss the question which we're doing. E raised to power x again. Okay, my question is, for what values of x the
ma'am screen upar kar do
yeah okay you want to see this part or like this here like this what are you saying
ma'am thoda sa upar ma'am note karne wala reh gaya
note karna hai okay okay fine beta
bas ma'am yahan pe rakh do ma'am
okay So, beta, there is one student, he is not able to understand Hindi. So, it will be nice if you can ask your doubts in English so that he also understands.
Okay, ma'am.
Is that okay, beta? So, try to...
okay, ma'am, done.
Yeah. It is okay for me, but for him, so that he doesn't feel that I'm not getting...
Ma'am, please speak in Punjabi.
Speak in Punjabi? But I don't know what.
Spamming.
Okay, fine. Okay, so it's because anyway we our medium should be English so that everybody is comfortable. Fine. And if somebody is not comfortable with English, he or she can tell me. I can sometimes repeat in Hindi or Punjabi also. I know, but we will try to keep it in English so that everybody understands. Right. So, can we go to the question? Because only 1 minute is left, 1 or 2. Okay. So, for what values of x? And don't worry, I will be doing the questions for this exercise in the next 2 lectures. So, you don't worry that you missed something or something like that. We will be discussing the questions in the next 2 lectures also. So, for what values of x, the Taylor series of f of x is equal to e raised by x converges to it, like itself. So what we are saying is that you are given a function e raised to power x, and we want to know that its Taylor series is convergent to itself or not, or for what values of x it is convergent. So you see, you will write the Taylor series for f of x is equal to e raised to power x. Let us just call it as about a equal to 0. So we just wrote the Taylor series already, or Maclaurin series. That is 1 plus x upon 1 factorial, x square upon 2 factorial, x cube upon 3 factorial, and so on. We know that. Now, what we will do, we are saying that Taylor's formula is e raised to power x is pnx plus rnx where what is RnX? RnX is n plus 1th derivative at C upon n plus 1th factorial x raised to power n plus 1, right? Where C is a number between 0 and x, right? Now, if we, all we have to check is, if limit n going to infinity Rnx is 0, then for those values of x, the Taylor series sum is equal to e raised to power x. Is this statement clear to everybody? Fine. Now we have to just look at Rnx. So let us see, Rnx, in Rnx, you need to compute n plus 1th derivative. So f of x is e raised to power x. We know that all the derivatives are same. So n plus 1th derivative of e raised to power x is, again, e raised to power x. So this Rnx will be e raised to power c, x raised to power n plus 1 upon n plus 1 factorial, where c is a number between, is between 0 and x. Now, you need to find this limit. And you don't know anything about C. The only information about C is that it is between 0 and x. So you have to first do something with this e raised to power C. So can you tell me something about e raised to power C? So you see, that depends on... Okay, so we have, if x is negative, it means that you have this situation. 0 here, x here, and C is somewhere here. So e raised to power c in that case is less than 1. Is that okay? If x is positive,
ma'am, e raised to power c kaise aaya, ye samajh nahi aaya ma'am, ye e raised to power c kaise aaya yahan pe?
Beta, n plus 1th derivative at c hai na, rn x is n plus 1th derivative at c. So f of x is e raised to power x. So what will be the n plus 1th derivative? That is e raised to power x. And in place of x, you write c, because this is the formula for rnx. Can you see? Ma'am. Okay, so when x is negative, your e raised to power c will be less than e raised to power 0, which is 1. And when x is negative, when x is positive, you have this situation, 0, x here, c here, right? In that case, your e raised to power c will be less than e raised to power x. So what will happen to Rnx in this case? In this case, your Rnx will be e raised to power c ki jagah pe, you will write 1 into is less than 1. Into x raised to power n plus 1 upon n plus 1 factorial. So limit Rn will be, what is this limit? 0. This limit here is 0 and Rn is positive. Okay, so you can just talk about mod of Rn. Okay, in this case, you will get limit 0. And here also, in the second case, when your e raised to power c is less than e raised to power x, so in that case, you will write mod of Rnx is less than is equal to e raised to power x into x raised to power n plus 1 upon n plus 1 factorial. And we have already seen that x raised to power n upon n factorial limit is 0. So again, in this case, limit mod of Rnx is 0. And if x is 0, in that case, your Rnx is 0. So it means that for all values of x, limit Rn is 0. For all values of x, limit Rn is 0. Therefore, e raised to power x is equal to 1 plus x upon this series for all x. Okay, but the time is up. Next class is there. I will explain this thing again in the next lecture. Thank you, everybody. Have a nice day.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.